Man to believed to be an Al-Qaeda member who escaped from a maximum security prison in Afghanistan was shown in a video broadcast recently urging his followers to attack the White House. In the video, escaped prisoner Abu Yahya al-Libi says, Allah will not be pleased until we reach the roof of the White House, and you have to learn how to use technology until you are capable of nuclear weapons. Well, that's great news, isn't it? Whether you believe it or not, it doesn't really matter. These people want to get their hands on a nuke and use it against us. If that happens, God forbid, how vulnerable are we? Shane Connor, he's the president of KI4U, a group that seeks to educate the public on nuclear survivability. Shane, if a nuclear bomb goes off, how many of us survive? Let's say one goes off in Washington, D.C.
Glenn, I'm glad to be here. There was a test done by the federal government a few years ago, or study rather, looking at a 10-kiloton weapon, terrorist nuke going off in Washington, D.C. This is about two-thirds the size of a Hiroshima bomb. And what they found in that study is that about 99% of the residents there in the Washington, D.C. area would actually survive. In other words, they would not only witness but survive the nuclear explosion. Now, we would end up losing 15,000 people from the blast, the initial blast. Another 15,000 would be injured and wounded. But overwhelmingly, 99% of the people would survive, as horrific as those numbers are. The biggest surprise to the American people when nukes do go off here in this country is that they will still be here.
You say that with such certainty, when nukes do go off here in America. What makes you believe that that is a certainty?
Well, I wish it weren't so. I have kids too, but we can listen to our government leaders. They're all telling us at the top level that it's no longer a matter of if, but when. Unfortunately, I'm convinced that we're going to see nukes in our future here in the U.S. Within our lifetime and perhaps not too far down the road.
You were with FEMA. This was your job with FEMA, wasn't it?
I've had some training with FEMA.
Okay.
I've taken some training with FEMA.
Okay. We never seemed to be prepared. I mean, we knew about the levees. I mean, I was on the air radio a year before saying the levees are not prepared for this, and yet we're building the same exact walls the levees that we had before. We're not ready for the next hurricane. We weren't ready for 9/11, yet we knew that it was coming. Our fallout shelters, I remember seeing the orange and yellow, or the yellow and blue signs that said fallout shelter. Those aren't even around anymore. The Geiger counters were taken out of our fallout shelter by Bill Clinton, were they not?
That's true. The first Bush administration after Reagan started defunding the radiological arm of FEMA, the Clinton administration totally shut it down. We had over 6 million Geiger counters, survey meters, and dosimeters distributed throughout communities from coast to coast. We had laboratories. We had people trained up in the use of them. And we don't today. All of that has been removed. The fallout shelters, the sirens, the evacuation plans, all of that's fallen aside. And what we need to understand is that most people today, and this also follows through to our government leaders, they are under these myths of nuclear unsurvivability. In other words, if you took a poll, most people feel that if nukes went off, everybody would die, or if you didn't, it would be so bad you wish you had. And that is patently false. The biggest surprise people are going to have is that they will still be here. The majority of people will survive. But without the proper training and even just modest preparations, they won't survive the next 2 weeks.
You know, Shane, I'm out of time, but give me the website where people can go and find that information.
www.ki4u.com. The letter K,
okay.
The letter I, the number 4, the letter U.com.
I would like to put you back in a time tunnel here and show you just a little clip of what we used to learn as kids with duck and cover. Can we roll that as we go out?
Duck and cover. That's the first thing to do. Duck and cover. First, you duck. Then, you cover.
You.
And you.
And you.
And you.
You.
And you.
And you.
And you.
Duck.
And cover.
tell you, there is more than that. If you're like me and you suffer from the fear of being vaporized, hang on. There is some hope out there.
Is the threat of impending nuclear annihilation giving you a headache? Well, now your worries are over. New from Exploitico Industries, it's Head Off, the new headache remedy guaranteed to instantly relieve headache pain. Just one simple application applied directly to the head, and voila, no more headache. Head Off is not intended for human consumption. Taking Head Off will result in premature death. Use with caution. What does this man have in common with Dr. Strangelove? Nope, it's not Doomsday. The answers on this week's podcast. Ask Glenn. Download it for free on iTunes or at CNN.com/Glenn.